Welcome back. It's 9:13, and here's what's new this morning. As the amount of people diagnosed with a mental illness increases, more people are turning to unique treatments for relief, and one of those is ketamine therapy. Margaret-Ann Carter is going in depth on the controversial treatment and the science behind it.
Yeah, some people have probably heard ketamine referred to as the horse tranquilizer, and while it is used by veterinarians, it's also used by doctors. So we check it out and see who's using it to treat depression, PTSD, OCD, anxiety, and chronic pain.
So we got 7 patient rooms.
And what they do is they come in, they get comfortable. We start a very small IV. We monitor their vital signs all throughout the infusion process.
Dr. Eric Oberg describing ketamine therapy.
Our goal is to get the patient to what's called a dissociative state.
Meaning hallucinogenic effects. That's because ketamine distorts the perception of sight and sound.
And that's what the literature in the last 10 years have shown us, is that that dissociative state is where the healing occurs.
Making the patient feel detached from their pain and environment.
So that's been the challenge, is that the knowledge of this treatment has been around for a very long time, but it's had those false stigmas attached to it that we have had to overcome. And there's still people that have a challenge with that.
Veteran and former first responder Jason Teamy is now the director of Greenville Ketamine Center. He says his life was transformed through this therapy.
The beauty is the things that it treats, especially post-traumatic stress and depression, I have seen and personally experienced.
But getting the word out doesn't come without outside skepticism.
We hear it every week that we are contributing to a street drug, that we are giving patients horse tranquilizers.
Ketamine is an FDA-approved medication, but only when used as an anesthetic for surgical procedures. It is not currently approved by the FDA for this kind of therapy. And while ketamine therapy isn't for everyone, Dr. Oberg says it can help with mental wellness.
These are patients that have tried all kinds of different medications and then have also done therapy. They've done electroconvulsive therapy, transcranial magnetic stimulation, and either didn't get the results or it just didn't work. And so we can take those patients and have an 85 to 90% success rate with ketamine. It was really remarkable.
Dr. Oberg says that the effects of ketamine wear off after an hour. He usually sees patients for 6 infusions over the course of 2 weeks. After that, booster treatments are determined on a case-by-case basis, and they can be anywhere from 2 weeks to 3 months. Now.